Happy New Year guys and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to see how the Grinch stole Christmas. Already I have drawn the movie scenes with pencil and outlined them with the pen. And also it took me almost 6.5 hours to completing coloring of this artwork. So I can't able to preview it to you guys. Sorry. Now let's get into the movie. How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Dr. Seuss. There is a village named Whoville and people lived there called Whos. All the Whos who lived in Whoville loved Christmas. But the Grinch who lived just above Whoville did not. No one knew why the Grinch hated Christmas. Maybe because his head was not screwed on right. But most guessed it was that his heart was two sizes too small. Every Christmas Eve, he stood staring down from his cave, hating the Whos so busy below, planning the Christmas day coming just tomorrow. The children down there would enjoy their toys and all the Whos would sit down to their Christmas feast, and after their feast, all the Whos in Whoville would stand close together with all the Christmas bells ringing. They would stand hand in hand and they would all start singing. "I must stop Christmas from coming," the Grinch growled to his pet dog Max. Then he got an idea. He made a Santa Claus hat and coat and dressed up just like Saint Nick. He took his dog Max and tied a big horn on his head to make him look like a reindeer. He tied Max to old sled and loaded some sacks and they travelled down the mountain towards the town of Whoville. The Whos were all sleeping on this night before Christmas. But as they lay asleep, the Grinch slithered down chimneys. And he took all the stockings, all the presents and decorations. He then took all the stuff and threw it up the chimney with glee. And then he even stuffed up the tree and then heard a small sound and turned to see. Little Cindy Lou who was 6 years old, she asked the Grinch, "Santa Claus, why are you taking our Christmas tree?" The Grinch thought up a lie and told Cindy Lou a light was broken and he was taking the tree to his workshop, then he would return the tree all fixed up. Cindy Lou smiled and went back to bed. He then stuffed the tree up and then he went to the fridge to take all the Whos feast. He took the Who pudding and even the roast beast. He took all the extras. He did the same thing to every Who house. He raced to the top of Mount Crumpit where he would dump all the Who's Christmas goodies. The Grinch put his hand to his ear to listen to the Who's boo-hooing. What he did here was quite a surprise. Every Who was singing even without all their presents. He then realized Christmas is so much more. And suddenly the sled was about to fall from the Mount Crumpit. He went so fast and grabbed the sled. Then his small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart grew, he raced back towards Whoville with all the presents and toys and all the food for the feast. The Whos of Whoville greeted him with open arms and invited the Grinch to their Christmas feast. And as the Grinch sat beside Cindy Lou, he carved the roast beast and they enjoyed the Christmas. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe for more videos and please share with your friends and family. Press the bell icon for instant notification. Also follow my Instagram ID, link in the description. See you guys. next time.